friends are in danger. I heard the people who took me talking about them.
Which friends, darling?
Mr. and Mrs. Rabe. Mr. Filbert. And I think they also said Otto's name.
Oh, I shall speak with them. You run inside.
Yes, Mother.
Your husband's friends may be in danger.
Just as he was.
How can we help?
You've done enough. My husband was a powerful wizard and couldn't defeat Harlow. The last thing we need is that monster coming after you.
We don't want to worry you. I'm sorry again about your husband, Mrs. Bickle.
Thank you. And thank you for bringing Archie home. I can never repay the two of you for your kindness.
Not to worry, Mrs. Bickle. My father used to say that rain does not fall on one roof alone. We are here to help each other. Learn more about Mr. Bickle's friends and why Harlow is after them. You'll be hearing from me as soon as I know something. Thank you for your help.
Nice to see you, my young...
Revelio.
Alohomora.
What do we have here? A demigod. Now, demiguys.
Anything to do with the dark art should be avoided. It's too risky.
Anything to do with Salazar Slytherin is worth the risk.
I can't agree. And I'll not say a word more. I'm sorry.
I won't give up.
What were you and Ominous speaking about?
He's being ridiculous. Apparently Salazar Slytherin had a secret scriptorium here in Hogwarts. Ominous swears it was used for the dark arts, so he wants nothing to do with it. I reminded him that Anne needs a cure. This scriptorium could hold the answers we need.
Ominous is right. Meddling in the dark arts is dangerous.
There's more to dark magic than people realize. The Gaunts know this better than most. Perhaps I've spoken out of turn. Ominous's family history is personal to him.
I'd like to know more about it, if you wouldn't mind telling me. I won't repeat it.
Very well. But do keep this between us. Ominous learned dark magic from his parents. Are you familiar with the Cruciatus Curse?
Crucio, correct? The Cruciatus Curse, also known as the Torture Curse, inflicts excruciating pain on the victim.
Apparently, his parents and older siblings had no qualms about casting it on muggles for sport. Ominous described the sound of the victim's cries as horrific, so the first time he was asked to cast it himself as a child, he couldn't bring himself to do it. As punishment, his family cast it on him. The anguish was so bad that when asked to cast it again, he relented. I have repeatedly assured Ominous that he did what he had to, but he still hasn't forgiven himself.
How horrible. Poor Ominous, he was only a child. He shouldn't blame himself.
After that incident, the rift between Ominous and his family only grew. That is until I came along. Every moment he isn't at Hogwarts, he's with us in Feldcroft. Ominous trusts me. And more often than not, he winds up listening to me. I'll remind him of that when I follow up about the scriptorium. Watch for my owl. I'll have news soon enough. I'll make Ominous understand. He'll change his mind.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind. Alohomora.
Thank you.
Revelio. What are you up to now?
You would be wise not to underestimate this student. Their aptitude for magic is beyond anything I've ever seen, and I've been teaching a long time.
It is a joy to have such a student.
It can be.
There you are.
I received your owl. I was able to speak with Lodgok, the goblin I mentioned before.
What did you learn?
He and Ranrok were close once, but they had a falling out.
You believe he can be trusted?
He seemed trustworthy. Difficult to know, really. But Sirona Ryan trusts him.
Well, that's something, I suppose. Supposing he can be trusted, will he help us get to Ranrok?
I retrieved a stolen helm that he hopes to return to Ranrok in order to regain his confidence.
You have been busy. Let's hope your efforts result in our learning something about Ranrok's plans.
Lodgok did mention that Ranrok is searching for something, but he couldn't say what. Perhaps that helm will yield some answers.
Ranrok is searching for something? I feared as much. I've heard an unusual amount of activity. Goblins and wizards, I surmise, when visiting my portrait at my castle.
Rookwood Castle?
My former residence, yes. That castle is also the location of your next trial.
You didn't see anything? Speak with anyone?
I did not. In fact, I did not make myself known. I only recently returned there, and did not recognize, nor trust, anyone that I heard. I stayed out of sight, so as not to tempt my portrait's destruction.
I'm sorry to tell you that Victor Rookwood, evidently your descendant, is a dark wizard in league with Ranrok.
My descendant? A dark wizard? I'm afraid we've no time to waste. Despite the obstacles that clearly await you, you must get to Rookwood Castle immediately. Not only is it the location of the next trial, it is home to a source of power that would be devastating in the wrong hands. I do wish we had the luxury of time. However, I do not doubt your abilities. Find my portrait there as soon as you can.
Very well, sir. I'm on my way.
Best of luck.
No time to waste. I'll meet you at Rookwood Castle.
Handy resource in... Revelio. Revelio.
Pressed ominous regarding Salazar Slytherin's scriptorium. Mm-hmm. My efforts were... Mm-hmm. Meet me outside the Slytherin common room.
Alohomora. Revelio.
You're here. Brilliant.
I received your owl. What happened with Ominous?
I told him none of us will be able to avoid dark magic forever. So the more we know about Salazar Slytherin and the dark arts, the better prepared we'll be. Unfortunately, only a gaunt knows the location of the scriptorium's entrance, and Ominous won't tell me.
Perhaps I should have a chat with Ominous.
You? I suppose it's worth a try. But don't get your hopes up. Ominous is annoyingly stubborn. Nothing new. I know where he is, I'll lead you to him and then leave you to it. Come on. He's this way. Keep an eye out. Never know who's watching. Although that hasn't stopped us before.
Strictly speaking, it has. We were caught.
Damned poltergeist. Such a nuisance. There he is. Good luck.
What are you doing here?
Hello, Ominous. Do you have a moment?
What is it? What have you and Sebastian been up to now?
I owe you an apology, Ominous. I wasn't honest with you before about the Undercroft. Sebastian did show it to me. He wanted me to have a safe place to practice some spells, to try and catch up to the other fifth years. He didn't think you'd mind.
I suppose that makes sense. It's just Sebastian's been pestering me lately about something and I'm frustrated with him.
Don't tell me he's still going on about... what was it? A scriptorium?
He told you about that.
He did. We were talking about Hogwarts founders and he mentioned it. Wouldn't say much more, though.
Yes, well, he seems to think it contains the answer to saving Anne. I think it's likely full of dark magic that is better left untouched.
Wait, you've never been inside?
Of course not. I only know about it because of my favorite aunt, Noctua. She thought like I do. Didn't agree with the family on the use of dark magic. In fact, she'd hoped to convince my family that there was more to Salazar Slytherin than worshipping pureblood status. She'd heard of this scriptorium and thought its contents might shed some light on him. She even found the secret entrance in this very corridor. She wrote regularly to my father about her efforts to gain access, and then she simply vanished. No one else ever tried to enter.
I'm sorry about your aunt. Don't you want to find out what happened to her?
Aunt Noctua went down this path with good intentions and lost her life. I don't want the same to happen again.
You don't know that history will repeat itself. Besides, you said your aunt thought like you. This could honor her memory. Get you answers about Slytherin and Sebastian answers for Anne. Your aunt pursued this alone. We could do it together.
I see what you've done here, and I confess, you've convinced me. I didn't think it possible. Very well. I shall tell you what I know. Fetch Sebastian, I'll wait. I hope we don't regret this.
Sebastian, over here.
These braziers grant access to the scriptorium.
Now you'll share? You wouldn't tell me when I practically begged.
It wasn't you who told me what I needed to hear. Opening the entrance has something to do with threes.
Well, three heads are better than one.
It's two heads are better than one.
And by that logic, three is better than two. Simple mathematics, Ominous. That brazier will tell us on its own. I wonder if it's a clue.
We're ready for this.
Repair.
The rubble formed a relief of a person facing a snake.
That must be the voice I hear.
A journal entry, signed by Noctua Gaunt.
Gaunt?
You hear a voice.
Your family was
here. It started when you repaired that relief. I hear a whisper saying, speak to me. I'm a parcel mouth. I can hear and speak to snakes. Nearly all known parcel mouths are descended from Salazar Slytherin.
I'd like to be able to talk to snakes.
You might not want the ability to speak parcel tongue. It's often associated with dark wizards. I haven't spoken it in ages, but I'd wager if I speak it now, the door will open. I'm hoping you're having second thoughts.
Believe me, I am having thoughts, but I'm still convinced we should go ahead.
It's ironic. When I left home, I vowed to leave the Dark Arts behind, and yet here I am. Stand back. I can't believe I'm doing this.
It worked! Ominous, you possess a rare ability indeed.
Between the two of you, I'm starting to feel left out.
Between the two of us?
I... never mind. There's no clear way forward.
Like a maze. Salazar Slytherin most likely wanted this to be difficult to solve.
The door we came from, it closed. And there's more than one gate ahead.
Then look closely at each gate for clues.
This journal entry, dial requires focus.
Art not be said the same. It may take practice solving. That didn't sound good.
Salazar Slytherin didn't make it easy. Isn't it?
You sound surprised. We're in a maze designed by Salazar Slytherin.
All the gates have symbols, and there are symbols on the dial.
The symbols did open it.
Was about to do that myself, but you got to it first.
Lumos.
Nice work.
Noctua references painful and arduous challenges, but also rewards.
painful. That's the part I'm wary of.
All I heard was rewards. Keep going. We've got more to solve ahead.
Search each corridor. It may not be obvious which leads where.
Another gate.
Seems Slytherin like to play games.
What's running the family?
Look in a mirror, Sebastian. That sounded promising.
Another dial solved.
Impressive.
Lumos.
Nice work.
Ominous. Your aunt wanted to change your family's traditions.
She did, and she was my favorite person in the world for it.
Another welcoming sword, was it? Excellent work. We're another step closer to the scriptorium.
Lumos.
I spotted something ahead. Looks troubling. The gate! I think we're locked in. Again!
Then Salazar Slytherin is not yet finished with us.
Ominous. A skeleton. And Noctua's last journal entry. She mentions being trapped here, blocked by an unforgivable curse.
This is where she died. This is where we'll die. I shouldn't have listened to either of you.
Ominous, I'm truly sorry about your aunt. But I know what to do. It's going to be difficult.
You said you know what to do.
Tortured faces on the door and Crucios etched into the stone. My guess is if we cast the Cruciatus curse, the door will open. That's why Noctua died. She had no one to cast the curse on. Ominous has the most experience with this. He should cast it. You seem to be in Ominous's favor. Will you ask him about this?
You know him better than I do.
Very well. Wish me luck. Wish we had some liquid luck. Ominous, I know this is the last thing you want to do.
Yes, it is. I thought you knew me better.
But this is different. Whoever you cast it upon would have agreed to it first. It wouldn't be an innocent victim. We have to open the door.
The spell won't work unless you mean it. That's true of all unforgivables. If it must be done, then one of you must cast it.
What do we do now? Ominous is not going to cast the Cruciatus curse again.
Ridiculous! As if dying in here is a better option than casting a damned spell.
It's up to us. I can teach you Crucio, or I can cast it on you.
Wait, you didn't say you knew how to cast Crucio.
Because I'm not sure I do. Ominous knows that, yet he's left us no choice. I don't yearn to follow in Noctua Gaunt's footsteps. I think I can cast it if I have to.
I want to learn the curse, but I won't cast it on you. You need to cast it on me.
I shan't forget this.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Are you all right?
Are you all right?
That pain, it was excruciating, but... Let's keep moving.
We made it. We found Salazar Slytherin's scriptorium.
I can't believe we're here.
Revelio.
Thank you.
Ravenia. Sebastian, Ominous, there's a book just here.
You found something.
You two go ahead. Let me know what's in it. I'll wander around a bit.
May I have a look?
What do you think?
Looks like a spellbook of some kind. This is incredible. A Hogwarts founder's possession. What an honor. Still can't believe Ominous never told me about his aunt and what she found.
What will you do with Slytherin's spellbook?
What I do with every book. Read it. Having professors as parents ingrained that habit early on. But I can do that later. For now, I say we explore this room. It's breathtaking. I don't want to leave, but I owe you, both of you. Without both of you, we'd never have made it this far.
We were lucky. We could have died.
Velia.
We must swear never to do this again.
I see a way out.
Best news I've heard all day.
Ominous, about your aunt.
Please, Sebastian. I meant what I said before. We swear, right now, never to engage in anything to do with dark magic again.
Understood. I'm truly sorry about your aunt, Ominous.
I suppose after all this, I am grateful to know what happened to her. Thank you. Thank you.
nice to see you, my